was all about me. This performance the Dark Place was putting on. But I had no control over it. I knew how utterly lost I was. The payphone was ringing again. The mystery caller was back at it. I had to find out more.
Alan Wake? Do you know who I am?
How the fuck could I?
Whoa! There's that famous temper. Lucky thing I'm not a paparazzi.
You keep jerking me around, refusing to tell me who you are.
You remember? You... Oh, fuck me. Alan, listen. Tell me, how much do you remember? Did you visit Parliament Tower? Did you find anything there?
Yeah. Alice is in danger. Scratch is reaching out to her, and there's another manuscript. Not initiation, return. I saw the title page. I don't remember writing it.
Return? Oh, man, this is what we're after. The Scratch can't have it. Our survival, the survival of the fucking cosmic everything depends on this. Come to me. Ocean View Hotel. I left my room key for you. It's right there on the payphone. Remember, the Dark Place works in loops and rituals. If the waves keep pushing you away, you just need to find another way in. We go with the flow of this ocean. Catch you soon, brother.
The Ocean View Hotel. A suspicious invitation to a shady meeting. Right on the money for the hard-boiled genre the whole city was built upon. The Ocean View Hotel. My destination. A loop that delivered me back to the street. What did the mystery caller said? If the waves keep pushing you away, you just need to find another way in. With only dream logic to lead me to the hotel, I looked to the neon signs for guidance. Was fragile, constantly under attack. There was no time to waste. The Dark Presence was only a step behind me.
You're the killer, the cult leader. It's in your eyes.
No! You've got the wrong man! It's Scratch! There's no time to lose!
You're going nowhere.
I had to find a way to escape before it was too late. Too late again.
This is my story. I just want to fight.
Too long. You'll end up a lost soul, haunting the streets and alleys, a faded out shadow, glimpsed by some other poor bastard on his way toward the same fate. Your broken dreams become a broken mirror, and the twisted reflection staring back at you with all the pent-up anger, regret, guilt, and shame was the monster you could never get away from.
How's the memory doing?
Sorry, who are you?
Kidding.
Good to see you, Tim.
You had me going.
Cozy place you got here.
You know, your disappearance from Bright Falls is still the only thing that folks talk about. Well, that and Deerfest. Is this where you ended up back in 2010?
You know about that?
I am the sheriff of Bright Falls. Or I was.
Are you related to Sarah Breaker? She was the sheriff of Bright Falls back in 2010.
Yeah, she's my cousin. I had a police sketch made of Dor based on my dreams. I sent it around and Sarah recognized the face from an old case file from the 80s. I moved out there to look into it and became sheriff after she left to join the feds.
So Deerfest is still a thing?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's bigger than ever. You know, I got zapped here right before it was about to happen.
Funny, me too. What was in the case file about Dor?
Not a lot of details in it. A local man named Warland Dor went missing near Cauldron Lake. Eyewitnesses claim he was struck by a bolt of lightning and just vanished. I never found any official records of a Warland Dor living in town or anywhere. Another dead end.
lights affected where the door led to. I could see the Ocean View Hotel. I was getting close.
Escaping, leaving all this sordid misery and terror behind. Getting in a car and driving till you see the sunrise. Somewhere where the sun still rises. Settling down, buying a house. Fixing it up, building a life. Finding someone. It's a fool's dream. It would all go bad. And having let hope in, it would be unbearably worse than this. You can take the man out of the city, but you can never take the city out of the man.
Barman, you caught my eye. The room was empty except for the projector. More games. Was the film a message waiting to be played?
this temple of shadow and mist, there's a window in the floor and a door in the ceiling. There's no knowing. Am I standing still or running or kneeling?
You're the one who's been calling me.
Indeed. I'm Tom Zane. Welcome to the House of Zane.
The poet. The diver. You look like me. How the hell?
Or maybe you look like me, you handsome devil. The diver was a beloved character I played in one of my films. I'm a filmmaker. A celebrated auteur.
I need answers. Why is return so important? What?
You always get worked up like this. Come on, I'll fix you a drink. We're in this together. Two artists collaborating, remember? Crafting the keys to our escape. Your magnum opus, Return, and its companion piece, my film. Sharing our life-altering visions, a melding of higher minds. Dreaming up our transcendental work of art. Here, in this room. 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 In this room.
It's return, but because we return.
And that is how the magic happened.
Enough of this bullshit. Alice is in danger. I need another murder site to go further. Back to Parliament Tower. Scratch is...
Your wife is safe back in the real New York. But Scratch is reaching for her through an overlap. Return is the key to escaping the dark place. You need to get it before that freak does. There's a murder site here in the hotel. Let the waves of your writing carry you there.
Hello?
They're on to us. If anyone asks, you were never here.
Thomas Zane had ended our talk in what felt like a paranoid fit. I had what I needed from him. There was another murder site in the hotel to guide me further toward my escape. I had to write my way to it. An idea nagged at me. I could almost reach it.
Back room. Whispers from the police radio kept me awake at night. The word through the ether. A murder in the backdrop of a play featuring a murder cult. How meta can you get? He said, looking knowingly at the camera. I could sense the cult of the word in this, and their leader, Mr. Scratch. Rumored to be Alan Wake, the writer who'd gone missing years before.
The hotel was a perfect setting for a Casey story. I was on the right path. I would start at the entrance lobby. The entrance hall set the mood where everyone had come in. The victim, the murderer, the detective. An idea, clear as a vision, waited for me here.
Thank you.
director of this play?
Yeah, that's me. Our performance of The Cult was cursed from the pre-show ritual on. The Cult is an immersive theatrical experience.
You're gonna have to walk me through what that means.
Immersive theater. A play where the audience can participate, spread across this hotel. The Cult is a legend. The only written copy of the manuscript lost, the play is passed on as oral tradition between theater companies. Each company only performs it once. The play was said to have special power. You were like kids playing with a Ouija board. And when you call for the devil, it will come.
The pre-show ritual. That's it. Set it up. Start from the beginning. I could use that shotgun. Layers upon layers. A play about a murder cult infiltrated by a real murder cult. The ballroom was where the pre-show ritual was held. The room at the end of the corridor was closed off. It felt significant. Something terrible would happen there. The prop room had been changed from room 104 to room 225. The troop were busy building their own Wicker Man, where they themselves would be sacrificed. Thank you.
parallel realities. Sometimes a quaint small town. Sometimes a hulking metropolis. Different every time we set upon the road that leads us there. And yet, like a half-remembered echo of a fading dream, always familiar to us. These are the stories that take place there. More inspiring, macabre, terrifying, heartbreaking, nail-biting, absurd, and thrilling. Sometimes all of these things at once. A haunting new season of mind-bending episodes written by Alan Wake. I am your host, Orland Orr, and I will see you soon in Night Springs.
It was locked from the other side. Could not be opened on this side.
Wake. Those ain't the words.
This is where they gathered before the play. This is where it began.
Why this hotel?
Because the rent is cheap? No. The ocean view was perfect for this. It's said to be haunted. Dark stories about murder, death, suicide. Supposedly, an actual cult once performed an unspeakable ritual to summon something in the ballroom. Did we summon the same thing? Tapped into something horrifying. It seemed like it was part of the play, but it wasn't. Does that sound crazy?
You don't want to ask me about crazy, kid.
A haunted hotel, yes. That's a trope for a reason.
Hey, Tim. New map, huh?
Yep. Look, I've never been to New York, but I can tell you that this ain't it.
I heard you humming again.
Yeah, I can't get this song out of my head. It's a real earworm. I hear it in my dreams.
I know that song you keep humming. It's the theme from Night Springs.
That old sci-fi show?
Sci-fi horror anthology. I used to write for a long time ago.
Look, it sounds a bit nuts, but I think the song is connected to Door. Or it's my subconscious telling me that this is all pretty out there.
The ballroom would be the stage of a key scene in the play. The cult in the play was called the Cult of the Tree. With their deer masks, they were the backwoods echo of the cult of the woods urban horror. My writer's room on the stage.
What was the scene in this room?
Well, this is what we call the writer's room. In the play, it's where the devil rewrites reality whilst God is asleep. The devil was our star role. I got a big time celebrity to play him, and he was method acting the role to perfection. He never broke character, always wore the cult mask. His name was scratched out on the posters.
Mm-hmm. And who was this mystery celebrity? Let me guess. Alan Wake?
I wish I could tell you, but turns out there were masks upon masks. Whoever he really was, shit got weird when he was around. Some of the crew joked that we'd actually hired the devil to play himself.
Mr. Scratch is the devil. He was born to play the role.
I had to agree with Casey on that. This was dark, but the story had to be dark.
This is not my writing. This is Scratch mocking me.
This was not the ritual murder site I was looking for. This had just been an appetizer before the main course. The devil's path up the staircase was draped in blood.
Wake!
I felt the presence of a new idea here.
Mr. Scratch, if that's who the actor playing the devil was, had stayed in the hotel. Asking around at reception got me a room number. 666. He had requested that room, specifically. The devil had a sense of humor. Or he really didn't. It was funny either way. According to the director, the actor hadn't mingled with the rest of the cast. He had only come out for the play, and always in character. Scratch had been here. I could sense his presence lingering in the room. I was about to have another killer idea.
Okay.
Let's talk about the murder victim. The lady who was killed in the climax of the play.
The leading lady. Oh, it was an honor to get to work with her. A grand dame for sure. She went back a long time. Kept insisting she had seen the long-lost original script of the play. She'd been with this mysterious writer, his muse. That was her role in the play. The muse.
She was staying in room 108, where the murder happened.
The set of the final scene, right. The devil comes, an unstoppable force crashing through the hotel through each scene, executed with devastating mastery. And all leading up to him meeting his muse. Turns out he knew her. He'd only joined the play to get to her.
To murder her.
Not you again. The dark presence had come for me. Drawn to the story I was writing as it grew darker. The muse was the murder victim. The final scene took place in room 108.
Freaking gumshoe dick asking too many freaking questions.
by that freaking gumshoe dick asking too many freaking questions. Not letting us proper police take care of it.
This is our chance to make the powers that be happy. We'll be set for life. Part of the inner circle.
Well, amen to that, partner. I like it. And so the fraternity, the club, the word. Our dear friends with many names. The way I see it, it was a lone nut job. A junkie out of his mind on some fancy new designer drug.
Open and shut case. All we gotta do now is dump the evidence from room 108 in the usual place in the alley.
This was the murder site. There was a record at the bottom of the bathtub, beneath the body. Somehow, it was important. Another step. Somehow, I was closer to home. Closer than ever before. It's you again. The FBI agent. Saga Anderson. I'm closer now. I can feel it. You helped me get closer to escaping.
Wake? Are you still trapped? Yeah, the clicker. We can feel
it. You know about the clicker. It can help us. I destroyed the dark presence with it last time. You can help. You can find it. You must find it.
I can get it to you. I have to understand. Did you write it? The story.
Alice is in danger. I have to stop Scratch. I have to find Return. I need to get back to my apartment. I'm writing a story to get through. Initiation. It's the only way.
The story.
You can do that.
You can write out.
It lasted only for a moment, like two planets passing in orbit. Saga Anderson was helping me go deeper, closer to escape. Somehow, I had to trust her. Parliament Tower. I had to get back to my apartment, my study. I had to find the manuscript of Return.